Good morning, everyone. This is Equine Cutie, and I'm going to be doing another home decor tutorial for you this morning. This one is going to be concentrating on making your bathroom more of a nice and kind of welcoming for when you have a party, or maybe you have some family visiting for a couple of days. Putting together a basket like what I'm going to show you can help your guests feel more relaxed and more comfortable in your home. So, I have a basket full of things here. Those are just some decorative touches. But I'm going to go ahead and take all my things out of this basket. I'm going to introduce you to the pieces that you can put in a basket for your guests. And then I'll show you how to put it back together so that it looks really nice. So one of the things I like to include in my baskets for my guests is a candle. I think these are really nice touches to add to your baskets, because if your guests want to relax and take a shower or a bath, they can light this candle and the scent will actually help them relax a little bit. This one specifically is Vanilla Cinnamon Brulee. I do recommend that if you're going to put a candle in the basket, that you make sure that it is a relaxing scent, such as vanilla, or a warm cinnamon, or an apple pie, or like a sugar cookie scent, or even a lavender scent. Lavender is really good for relaxing. I really prefer lavenders and vanilla scents, but warm sugar cookie scents are also very good for this. So you can include a candle. It's always very relaxing. Sorry about that. Also include a body wash. This is specifically for the guests who will be staying overnight with you, or for a couple of days in your home. I recommend providing a nice body wash that is hypoallergenic, because you never know, some people might be allergic to strong perfumes, and making sure that you have a sensitive skin, body wash for them to use is a very good idea. This one is Dolce de Vanilla. It's just a vanilla body wash. It's got calming elements in it, and it smells really good. And including one of these in your basket just helps your guests to feel more at home and relaxed. So always include a body wash. This is important, especially if you have female guests, because girls like to makeup. This is an apricot natural facial scrub. I'll show you really quickly. It has, it kind of has the consistency of toothpaste, but if you can see the little black dots in there, it's an exfoliant. And what it does is it exfoliates your hands and your face. You can use this in the bathtub to, you know, exfoliate the rough edges of your elbows or on your feet. It is a facial scrub, so it is intended for your face, but if you'd like to use it on your elbows or your feet, that's fine too. But this will help take off any makeup that your guests have been wearing that day. And it'll just help them have a clean, fresh face to go to bed. And then they can also use it again in the morning when they wake up. Just provides that clean and fresh feel. I'm going to wipe my fingers off. The next thing that I always include, especially if I'm having a party, is a lint roller. Now, providing a lint roller will It just allows your guests at the party to, dust off any lint or little fibers that get on their clothes, like if they're wearing black or like navy blue or something. Oops. Sorry. This lint roller, it's just very nice. The lint rollers are a good idea, because then your guests can still feel like their outfits are, clean and very presentable. And I know a lot of people don't particularly like putting a lint roller in there because they kind of feel that it's tacky or cheap. I always have one in my bathroom for my guests, because then they can go in and just really quickly brush the lint off of their dress or their suit and, come out presentable again. So I always include a lint roller. I like to include different kinds of lotions because not everybody has the same lotion preference. This one is a lovely citrus scent, and I like to provide this one so that in the morning my guests can, put it on and it smells like oranges and very bright citrus, so it kind of provides a nice little wake up, a little note of, just waking up. New day type of scent. So I recommend providing a lotion like this. I also supply a cucumber melon lotion in my basket. This one has a nice, clean, refreshing scent. I like to put it on my hands after I've just like after I've just washed my hands. I'll put a little bit of this on, and it helps that clean, fresh scent linger really well. So the cucumber melon is a nice one to include. Another nice one to include is a sensitive skin formula. And the reason I suggest sensitive skin formula is because sometimes people are allergic to a large amount of perfumes or certain oils that are used in lotions. And if you provide a sensitive skin formula like this oatmeal and shea butter blend, it's very soothing to the skin, and your guests can use it after they shower or just in the morning or just to like calm down itchy skin. So it's very good to have a sensitive skin formula. Another thing I always include, especially for my overnight guests, is a little hairspray. The reason I include this is because, they may not have their curling iron with them and they want their hair to stay in place. So by providing a little can of hairspray, well, in this case mine's a big can, but by providing a little bit of hairspray, your guests can fix their hair up and look presentable in case you want to go out to maybe brunch the next day. Perfumes or body mists are also very good to include. This is one of my personal favorites. This is actually my bottle of perfume. I just put it in here because I don't have the other bottle that I usually include. But it's always nice to put a perfume in there, or a body mist. That way your, and then put one for male and female. That way your guests can, it's another step to help them feel more comfortable and fresh and presentable when they're staying at your house. Now, the number one thing to include in your basket is a hand towel and a washcloth. Now, this fold I've seen a couple other whisperers do. The only one I can think of right now. Well, there was a whisperer that did this fold, and they stopped making videos, so I can't recommend her, his anymore, excuse me. Gentle Whispering does this fold as well. I did this fold in my towel origami video. My mom showed me how to do this. But, if you're looking for more fun towel folding things or towel folding ideas to help present your towels to your guests, you can see my video, which is Towel Origami, or you can visit Gentle Whispering for her towel folding tutorial. She does a very good job, and she's got a couple of really nice ones that I've tried in my home, and I get lots of compliments on them as well. So please see her video, or go ahead and take a look at mine if you'd like. I'll show you how to fold this really quickly. But for more in-depth ones, you can see my towel origami video or gentle whisperings video. So, towel and a washcloth. And you'll need the basket. So, when you don't have to have a basket that is this big, or even one with little handles. You can have a tiny one. Mine's just this big because of how much stuff I put in it. So I'm going to go ahead and set the basket to the side. Actually, I'll show you. There's a couple of ways you can decorate the outside of the basket to make it look more relaxing. You can take little flowers and sort of stick them into the basket. Just pull it through. Like this. And just weave them through the basket. So you could put flowers in like that. You could use a shiny ribbon. This is just a gold satin ribbon that I have. And depending on your basket, you'll have to tie it differently. But I'll just show you on this basket how it would look. Pull it up through the handles, like that. I'm going to turn this so I can see. Take the loose ends, pull them through the bottom, like that. Pull it so it's tight. And then I'll go ahead and just tie it in a bow. Okay. So you get this nice kind of with the flowers and then the pretty bow, and it's just relaxing. I'm going to go ahead and take the bow off. If you're not incorporating your towel into this, you can leave the bow on just to make it so that it's a little more, pretty to look at. A little prettier to look at. Put that over there. I'm going to show you very quickly how to fold the towel. So, you want to make sure you incorporate your hand towel as well as your washcloth. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. I'm going to fold my towel. I have an embroidered edge on my towel, so I'm going to go ahead and fold it up. Like this. Kind of in half. I'm going to smooth it out. Make sure that everything stays. Then I'm going to fold it into thirds. Just like this. So that we have this type of a pocket, pouch type thing here. So that I have that. Then I'm going to take my washcloth. I'm going to do an accordion type fold with my washcloth. And just one more time. Line it up so that it stays. Oops. I'm going to fold it in half like this. So it looks kind of like an accordion. And I'm going to set it in my little pouch. Just like that. And spread it out a little bit so that it looks kind of fancy. Okay. Take my basket. going to drape this over the front of my basket so that it looks a little presentable, like that. Okay, now I'm going to go ahead and arrange. By putting your products in the basket, you'll hold the towel into place. Lotion in the middle. And put the other two lotions on the same side. Go ahead and put the body wash here. And the lint roller to the side. Set our candle right in the center. Our face wash and our perfume. So you've got this very beautiful guest basket, and if you want to add a little more touch to it or a little more decorative pieces, you can take some fake flowers, just put them right there on the top. Or if you don't want to put that many, you can take individual flowers like this, and you can just, you know, you can put them in the front, stick them through the sides of the basket, just by the other flowers that you did, like this. Or you could even add colored flowers if you want to. You don't have to. But you could put a couple of colored ones that maybe match your bath towels or something. And it'll just kind of give it a more fun, festive edge and appearance. So this is a way to make a fun guest basket for your guests. I know there's a couple summer holidays coming up. So, this is just a fun way to make your bathroom look more welcoming to your family or your guests for your party. I hope you guys enjoyed this home decorating video, and I will see you all again very soon. Have a great day.